What is going on, guys? Judo Sloth here, and welcome to my latest strategy guide. This is for the Town Hall 8 Dragloon attack, and honestly, this is one of the strongest attacks right now for the 3-star. You can take on a variety of base layouts. We'll go over generally what you're looking for, as well as give you a troop composition to use, and try and break things down into 5 simple steps so that you can copy and learn the attack strategy a little bit easier. But please do adapt the troop composition and strategy judging on the base layout that you're attacking. So if we first look at troop composition, a lot of your spells are going to consist of a Zap Quake combination because you're going to take out an air defense straight off the bat with that. You're then going to want all dragons. Now you can drop a dragon or two and take some of your own balloons. Depending on the layout, it might be that there's defenses on the outside. You might even take some minions if there's some buildings you can easily snipe off in the corner of the maps and save your dragons to target them to an air defense. But then you want to have a rage spell to help push the dragons to that air defense. You're then finishing off this composition with balloons in your clan castle and a clan castle haste spell in order to push them balloons to the other air defense. So that is your plan for the 3 air defense. You also have to bear in mind the air sweeper, but generally your whole plan of this attack is based around taking out the 3 air defense. Now we've introduced the attack strategy enough, we could go in a bit more depth about base layouts, but let's just get straight into the attack, break down the 5 different steps, and then as I show you the next lot of replays, we can tweak the tutorial just so that you can see how it works on different base layouts. So it's really figuring out which air defense you're going to take with which method. Now the hardest to get to air defense, you will Zap Quake, which is step 1 of this strategy. Your 2 lightning spells and an earthquake spell, and make sure you're utilizing that earthquake spell to get damage on surrounding structures. You can see that I'd got damage on the other air defense in this first replay. Step 2 is then to funnel your dragons. You can see I'm sending in the dragons to that most northern air defense coming in behind the sweeper, and it's important you get the bulk of your dragons to it. We'll give you tips on how to funnel the dragons effectively in the next replay, but step 3 is to rage your dragons to the air defense. It's important that you get the dragons to that air defense as soon as possible, so the far side of the spell just touches it and the dragons get through the buildings up to the air defense quicker. We've already done step 4, but that is bringing in the balloons to the back air defense. Now you do this as soon as the clan castle troops are drawn to your dragons from step 3. You do not want the clan castle troops coming across and taking out your balloons. You need to make sure that you're utilizing the haste spell in the same manner as the rage spell to help your balloons get to that air defense. It's always difficult to get these steps in the first replay, we will tweak them, but step 5 is to use your king on the back side of the base in order to distract the defenses as your balloons and dragons are coming through. Now this is obviously archer towers that you're mainly wanting to distract. Now you want to do this because the main threat for your dragons and balloons, the air defense, you've already taken care of. But the archer towers are air targeting defenses which can be just sniping off your dragons if they're sitting right at the back. They do have a decent radius that they can attack from. So in order to try and maximize the troops that you still have alive and really give you the best DPS, you might as well lose a bit of health on your king to distract for them defenses. Moving on to the next base, this one is a bit more difficult because it is an 8.5, but when we break down the attack, it works very effectively against it. So because we have 4 air defense to contend with, one of them is a very low level, so it's not really as big of an issue, but we want to focus the dragons towards where the 3 of the air defense are. So I'm zap quaking the air defense up in the north, and then you can see there's 2 air defense at the bottom here. One of them is that very low level. That's where I'm going to funnel the dragons towards. And that's because they'll be able to bulldozer them 2 air defense whilst I bring my balloons in towards the other one. So I have used the dragons to funnel right around this south side, and then using the rage spell again to get my dragons to that air defense. They are attacking straight into an air sweeper, and I've also brought the balloons in very quickly over on the west, because you really want that third air defense down as soon as possible so that it's not sitting picking off your dragons. So we've flown through the different steps. Step 5, we have the king distracting this archer tower down in the south so that the dragons can move through, and once you're up to this stage, the only way you can alter the outcome of the raid is to use your king's ability. So it really is focusing on when you can press that. Bear in mind though that when you press it, he is going to be enraged and speed up, and you don't want him to run outside of the radius of the archer tower he's tanking for, so it really is just monitoring the attack. On this one, I pressed the ability to get him back in front of the dragons to then try and tank for the archer tower up in the east of the base, which I know is low level, but it still makes a difference. Now once you're at this stage, it is just watching the dragons take out the rest of the base. Now you do want to be cautious of time, so the different stages that we've just gone through, you do want to try and be as effective as possible with that. So for example, once you've taken out the first air defense with the Zap Quake, you don't then want to sit waiting 5 seconds or so before you start putting the dragons in. You want to plan the attack beforehand so you know exactly when you're going to move on to each stage. Yes, you need to be able to adapt the attack as you're moving through, but you don't want to be losing valuable seconds because your dragons need to clean up at the end of the raid. But most of the time, if you do this effectively, it really isn't an issue. And a nice little game that I like to play is to see how many dragons I can have left over at the end of a raid. The next replay, which is a max Town Hall 8, virtually a max Town Hall 8, I have 9 out of 10 dragons survive, so very impressive. Make sure to drop me a comment if you have all 10 dragons survive in a raid. So for step 1 and zap quaking the air defense, we're going to take the central air defense on this one because it's the most difficult to get to, and with the earthquake we can get some damage on the buildings around it. The town hall, which obviously has higher HP, is included within this. The other two air defense are fairly easy to get the balloons to. They'll track onto the archer tower and then straight onto the air defense with either of them, but I'm going to bring the dragons into the air defense on the southeast because it's more central, so it's slightly easier to funnel the dragons towards, and also we'll be coming in behind the air sweeper. So step 1, we've already discussed which air defense we're taking out in this raid. We're going to take the one in the center. As soon as this goes down, we're not wasting time, the dragons will be straight in to start funneling. So I've picked buildings on either side that are out of range of that air defense, so I can just be patient, let the dragons take them out, and then it means I can send the bulk of the dragons in towards that air defense because they're not going to be drawn to the buildings on the outside. In its absolute simplest form, if you're not used to funneling, you could just put a line of dragons right across this southeast side, or whatever side you're coming in from, and the dragons would naturally sweep from one side of the base to the other and take out that air defense in the process. But if you want to be most effective and get the bulk of them in, get that air defense down as soon as possible, then you have to funnel your dragons taking out them buildings, and you can see how I had a big group of them go straight into that air defense. The rage spell, which is step 3, helped them through that, and then as soon as the clan castle was occupied, the balloons came in at the back end towards the air defense in the north. They took that out just before the dragons coming through became into its radius, so you could see how effective that was in terms of keeping the dragons alive. I've then used the king on the back end to tank for one of the archer towers. If I had adapted my raid quick enough, I would have seen that the balloons coming through were already targeted by the archer tower, so I could have used my king to the archer tower on the very west of the base, but it's not going to matter. We've planned the attack to take down them air defense so effectively that you can see we have them 9 out of 10 dragons survive, and time most certainly is not an issue when you have that many dragons left up. That is how effective this attack is, guys. Now you will have a good chance at taking out almost any Town Hall 8 with this attack strategy, but really what you're looking for in base designs are layouts where you can really single out them air defense and take them down with each of the different methods. Now obviously the Zap Quake combination, that really doesn't matter where that air defense is situated, but you want to be able to funnel your dragons easily in towards one air defense. You can see the one in the very north here we can do in this layout. And obviously you want to be able to track them balloons to the other air defense quite easily as well. Now make sure when you're planning the attack out that you keep in mind, balloons will move over the center of a defense. So when you're planning where they're going to path, you need to keep that in mind. For example, in this layout, from the Archer Tower in the very south, it is one tile shorter to the air defense than the Wizard Tower from the very center, so I can be confident that the bulk of balloons will go to it. Now, it depends on how quickly the Archer Tower goes down. Some balloons that are lagging behind might then be drawn to the Wizard Tower, but you know you're going to get that air defense. Now we decide to Zapquake the air defense in the west. We could have probably tracked balloons to this as well. Sometimes it is just 6 2/3 in terms of which one you take out, but if there were a hidden Tesla just to the right of that Archer Tower, it could skew our balloons around. I don't think there is, but it's always best just to make sure. So step two, I funneled the dragons in, made sure not to put too many in the path of that air sweeper. Step three, the rage spell pushed the dragons in to take that out. And as soon as the clan castle dragon moved across and was drawn to my dragons, I then put the balloons in towards that air defense at the very south. And notice how I switched around step four and five and used the king to distract for the balloons going in so that they could keep some of their health, because as the dragons move through to the very end of the base, they'll end up on the east. There's not actually a lot of air targeting defenses for me to distract with the king, so he'd be kind of wasted over in that corner. That's where it's always that same cliche of adapting the strategy to the base. Now, I always try and keep my guides as simple as possible because that's how I learned, and I always think that if you have a good baseline and kind of different stages and steps to try and follow, you can then learn the strategy a little bit easier, mimic it, and then adapt accordingly and advance your skills like that. So I always do try and give you a troop composition and a step-by-step with all of my guides. Now, just to give you a couple of ideas of how I sometimes tweak this strategy, if the king isn't going to be very useful on the back end, if there's not many air targeting defenses there, I'll sometimes use him to distract at the start, but also you can use him to funnel for the dragons as well. If there are a lot of archer towers where you're coming in from, you can take a balloon or two just to sneak in and try and take them down a little bit quicker. If there's builder huts in the corner, I often drop a dragon or two out of my army so I can take some minions. It really does depend what you're aiming for. In this final replay of the video, we'd already had an attack on this base and I knew there was a hidden Tesla over there by the builder's hut, so I took a couple of my own balloons in order to take that straight down. I'm not really going to go over the different steps for this final replay. Hopefully at this stage you've kind of learned the different stages that I'm going through and you can see exactly what I'm doing in the background. This final replay is kind of an example of showing how strong the attack is, especially when things don't exactly go to plan. And it's a little bit different in this one because the dragons are coming through towards the air defense, but because they're both a little bit central and kind of a bit funky to track the balloons to, I use the dragons first and bring the balloons in behind them so that the dragons have taken out some of the defenses first, and it means the balloons can track a little bit easier to the air defense. I used the king to distract originally as well and made sure that although I came in from a corner, I'd loop the dragons round in a bit of a horseshoe fashion to funnel them directly down to the air defense, which were right in the center of the base for this one. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this guide for the Town Hall 8 Dragloon, which is honestly one of the best attack strategies right now in the game for this Town Hall level. If you use this attack strategy, please share your successes down in the comments below and provide any other tips for other viewers as well, because I appreciate people do things differently. I might not have covered every single thing in this guide. Any other questions, please do ask me as well. I'll try and answer as best as I can, and subscribe for more Clash of Clans guides. I've been your host, Judo Sloth, and until next time, peace out, guys.
Stay tuned for more Clash of Clans.